Yep, there's another way water can get into the air. The water on the doghouse roof dried pretty fast in the warm sun. This water disappears faster because the stove is hotter. This change from water we can see to water vapor we can't see is called evaporation. The cloud from the spout of the tea kettle is condensation of the water vapor from the tea kettle hitting the colder air. The hot water in the kettle gives off water vapor to the air by rapid evaporation, just as rivers, lakes, and ponds give off water vapor to the air by slow evaporation. As the hot, water-filled air hits the colder air near the ice tray, the water vapor turns into clouds of tiny water droplets floating in the air, condensation. When the air is quite cold and cannot hold any more water droplets, they collect together to form larger drops, as on the ice tray. And being too heavy to float in the air, they fall back to the earth as rain. Without water in the air, we couldn't live. Our fields would be dry, and nothing would grow. The hot water in the kettle gives off water vapor to the air by rapid evaporation, just as rivers, lakes, and ponds give off water vapor to the air by slow evaporation. The hot water in the kettle gives off water vapor to the air by rapid evaporation, just as rivers, lakes, and ponds give off water vapor to the air by slow evaporation. The hot water in the kettle gives off water vapor to the air by rapid evaporation. Just as rivers, lakes, and ponds give off water vapor to the air by slow evaporation.